मैं इंट्रोडक्शन चैप्टर शुरू किया था तो दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शन चैप्टर दैट इज क्रेडिट मैनेजमेंट। तो विदाउट वेस्टिंग आवर टाइम लेट अस स्टार्ट द टॉपिक एंड इन बिटवीन दैट इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट यू वुड आस्क मी। ठीक है, आप मुझे पूछ लीजिए। तो नाउ बेसिकली क्रेडिट मैनेजमेंट, व्हाट वी कॉल एज क्रेडिट मैनेजमेंट, इट्स अ प्रोसेस थ्रू विच वी बोरो मनी फ्रॉम आउटसाइडर्स। राइट, द आउटसाइडर्स कैन बी सपोज वी आर अ बिजनेसमैन, तो बीइंग अ बिजनेसमैन वी नीड फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट फॉर द ऑपरेशनल पर्पस। तो फॉर द ऑपरेशन पर्पस व्हेन वी सीक और व्हेन वी रिक्वायर फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट इन दैट केस वी अप्रोच बैंक और द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन और द मनी लेंडर। तो फ्रॉम वेन यू बोरो द मनी दैट इज द क्रेडिट। राइट, तो इन दैट क्रेडिट नो डाउट वी गेट फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सोर्सेज। नाउ थिंग इज दैट वट एवर मनी वी हैव बोरोड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सोर्सेज इज एक्चुअली मैनेज प्रॉपरली। राइट, ऐसा नहीं कि यू नो एज पर आवर कैपेसिटी और एज पर आवर वो कंडीशन और एज पर आवर फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन always ensure to borrow the money accordingly from the market so that we could meet the financial obligation. Right, and we can maintain our position for a longer period. So the company or a business can borrow money from n number of sources, but question arises, whatever money they borrow from the outsource, they have to you know pay them on time or they could able to utilize that money in a proper way. So the process or the system in which we manage our credit is known as credit management. So credit management today we will cover up not many things under that. So today's this topic will cover the second part of credit management will cover the common advantages and disadvantages. Okay? Of business using credit, or what are the credit advantages and disadvantages? Basically, we know that, but let us just go and once again let us regain the ideas what are there. Now, then we have the cost of credit. How you are going to determine the cost of credit? Because it is not free that you know from any source you can borrow money without paying any extra. So on credit we have to pay something extra, and that extra amount is known as cost of credit. So we will know that how to calculate the cost of credit, then the main factors examined for granting credit. And suppose we are giving credit to somebody, so we have to know what are the factors need to be considered while granting credit. Or if you are asking money to somebody, then we have to know also what are the things you have to maintain, so that easily we may get financial support from that bank. Now then the credit documents, what are the documents which is required, then the regulations on credit to manage it in a proper way, in a systematic way and legal way. Now the credit assistance, all these things we will cover in this topic. So basically the credit, when we talk about credit, as I told you, the money that we borrow from outsider or the borrowed amount is known as credit for us. And the different type of there are the two type of credit in the last class we have covered up. So I'm just going to give you some insight of that. So what are the different type of credit we have basically? So consumer credit and commercial credit. So consumer credit is for individuals. They are using their debit card and credit card to purchase something. And then we have commercial credit that is basically used by the industry, transactions and business trade purpose. So that is commercial credit. So we will see the different type of consumer credit in which we have. Like credit cards, we have different type of accounts which we have covered up in the last one. Now, the advantage is because it plays a really major role in the credit that we should know, because what are the advantages or what are the pros and cons of the credit facility. So that thing you have to know before already. Then you have to know that how do you establish the credit, right? How in an organization is going to establish the requirement of the credit, how to measure that, how to calculate that, or how to determine that, and what are the sources of loans, or what are the different avenues for the loans you have in the business world, that is in the system. Then how do you source with the help of the various offering companies or business finances that are getting credit. Then we should know about good credit, what is a good credit. Okay, that thing we cover up in our topic, because all the credits come out good, because it is also charging you high interest on a particular amount, which is not even, which is highly risky for you to take. In that case, that is not a good credit for you. Because, the other example is the case, being an individual, suppose you have some financial requirement. And to meet your financial requirement, you have public sector grant and you have government grant. So, as you know, if you are going for a government grant, then you are quite safe. In terms, so for the risk is concerned, because they are going to verify all your documents, they have to verify accordingly. The bank will consider your request by seeing your credit worthiness, and accordingly, they allow you to make the payment. It is very systematic and flexible. But so far, the private banks are concerned, they are no doubt they are going to consider the application very quickly, and they release the loan amount within a short time of time. And for that facility, they are charging high interest on the loan amount. So again, maybe you are getting. It takes less time, also time consuming process, but for that time consuming process, the individual has to pay at least paying a huge sum of amount to the company as a return or as an interest. So that thing also we have to see if we are good credit for us and if we are bad credit. Then I want to know what is credit before, because whenever we take any credit from any source. Now you might be knowing being an individual where you are asking for the credit, then in that credit, the bank needs to check our civil score, right? So every credit generates some report, and your paying behavior, will decide a lot of things. So credit report also we will know, then what are some time and of a debt problem, that also we will see, and what is bank proxy. Finally, that we know when we could not able to meet our debt, when we could not able to fund debt, or when we could not able to, maintain our debt, then finally, we, after a certain point of time, after the rules and regulations, we may be declared as a bankrupt. So, we will consider all these things. So, in the second part, we will see the advantage and disadvantages of using credit. Okay. As you could see here, this is just as many as four. The advantages of using credit. So credit has what advantage for us? See, people have lot of demand and need in their life. So to meet that requirement of their life, banks have the credit facilities, or they extend their credit facilities to be available. So that they will fulfill their need and requirement. So for that reason, in this credit, the business advantage of using credit is that if we consider in the business form, then in that case, the advantages are like they can go for, insurance, they can build a positive credit history, they can purchase a device to the business credit, large purchase into the government through credit. Even if they do not have the adequate amount in their bank account, they should be able to purchase the thing. It reduces the need to carry cash. Okay, instead of carrying the cash, they are taking the loan directly from the bank and they are purchasing the thing. So these are basically the things which have been supported by the they are getting this type of advantages in a business. While using the credit. So, taking credit also is good thing because it shows that how serious you are for your business and it's establishing a favorable credit rating for you. Because the company, if it takes loan and they repay the amount on time, then this is definitely their performance is going to improve and they get some good rating in that. So what is the advantage of that to you that any point of time that business requires and there is an urgency of time or there is some important project that has to execute and for that time to support that can be to grow this credit. So this is what the advantage we used to get. And also, we have seen keeping business separate from the personal expenses. It's always better that when we are using the credit, to meet the business requirement, what the requirement is high, we can use the credit facility for personal expenses. We can, so far they are separate entity, individual and the business are separate entity. The business can fulfill their requirement through their own credit facility. As an individual, we can, the individual can meet their financial obligations and the requirement in case own, as per his own personal credibility. So these things are separated and according to the business and according to the individual requirement, they can, distinguish the credit facility and they can use the facility. Now, it's minimizing the record keeping and receipt. So basically, when we take using the credit facility, we minimizing the record. And it generates the receipt because, suppose we are going to abroad for a business trip, in that case, we are using the credit card and keeping record how much expenses the business is incurring abroad trip. Okay. So in that case, all the payments which have been made through my credit card. So in that case, all this amount can be recorded and it can be monitored for future use as well. Now, keeping track of what employees are spending. Right? So there are some companies who they provide credit card facilities for the marketing purpose and the employees moving one place to another. So in that case, instead of using that place, they are just giving a credit card. All the expenses have been recorded in a systematic manner and it can be tracked easily. Now, again, while entering the credit facility, the business also they are getting the that reward point like as we are getting now credit card. So credit card is a good example for that. So these are the business advantages which we have discussed. Now let us focus to the disadvantages. So advantages we have seen, now disadvantages. So disadvantages of using credit is again what are the common thing we have? Inviting cardholders to spend more money. So people say, credit card will be like anything. They say, the experts say, using credit card is not a good habit because, you encourage you to spend more and more because you think that you have a particular amount in your pocket and whatever need and requirement you have at a particular point of time. So far, it increases your, purchasing power, so you are going and you are not having control or you are not maintaining your expenses record in that because you have to take it back and you are spending more and more after you leave that facility or that particular thing is a disadvantage for an individual as well as facility. Now, credit card can be stolen. So, in that case, there are many cases where credit card has been stolen because it doesn't require any like checking and personal information. And so far nowadays the security has been security policy and system has been enhanced when you are getting a message after swapping credit card. But again there is always a risk that if the credit card would be stolen that it can be used by anybody. So it's a risk factor while using the credit. Now, bigger charges, so expenses also, we have the credit card, whatever we are using for the shopping and for fulfilling the minimum requirement. In that case, we are paying some bigger charges if we could not able to pay the amount on due date. So again, it has some advantage, disadvantage. But as we know, the business needs credit credit support to meet their day-to-day requirement or to meet their future project plan. So for that reason, credit is required. And you know, these companies with assets may also have some liability as well. So in that case, we never know that you know, without credit, whether I could able to meet my future expenses or not. So that's why the future is uncertain. So we do not know what would be the business condition after a particular point of time. So we may need financial support, and when we need a financial support, we have to take credit. Right. Now, here we have expression type of the customer support and in the database of credit cards we have seen many times. Now, overbuying by employees is happening many times. So, these are the very broad areas where, you know, these are the major disadvantages. Then, overusing credit cards, meaning support, you know, the expenses is not. You know, when you are using credit card, you could not have to prioritize that which things you have to purchase. So, it may be difficult to control our interest. You know, when you are using credit card, you are going for you know, that movement or you are going for a work and anyway you are finding something. And if you know, on the way that particular thing is very lucrative to us, then you are going and purchasing it. So, credit card is unnecessary expenses, which is not required. So, this is the advantage, disadvantage that you have covered. Now, we will see that what is the cost of credit. So, no doubt, working without credit, as you understand in the business, is difficult to manage. But, whenever you are thinking for the credit, are we thinking about the cost? Because, why in business mode? A wise individual, he before using his credit card or credit facilities, he always thinks twice that what would be the cost. And that is the only factor which restricts an individual to use it more frequently. So, cost plays a major role because no doubt you have the credit facilities, but you cannot avail it for unnecessary purposes. So if the purpose is most important or it is necessary to be fulfilled, in that case, for that purpose, whenever you are planning for taking a credit, so while thinking for taking a credit, you have to consider the cost aspect of that credit. So with this, we will see that how to determine the cost of credit. That is, we need out. That is the Abhishek is out. Hello.
Hello.
हाँ राकेश जी अभी तक तुम
सर
डाउट
नहीं डाउट तो नहीं है सर थोड़ा सा सर आपका वॉल्यूम कम आ रहा है सर आवाज
ओके
मतलब
ओके तो सुनने में तो आ रहा है ना राकेश जी सुन पा रहे हैं ना आप
हाँ जी सर
ओके
अभी अभी एकदम ठीक है
सुन पा रहे हैं ना आप
हाँ जी सर जी सर
ओके अभी अभी तक कोई डाउट नहीं है
नहीं नहीं
ओके ओके तो हम लोग अभी कॉस्ट ऑफ क्रेडिट शुरू करेंगे अब देखेंगे कि क्रेडिट का कॉस्ट कैसे निकालेंगे तो लेट अस स्टार्ट में तो एज आई टोल्ड यू कॉस्ट ऑफ क्रेडिट इज समथिंग दैट विच रिस्ट्रिक्ट एन इंडिविजुअल टू यूज हिज क्रेडिट फैसिलिटी सो फ्रीक्वेंटली बिकॉज वी अंडरस्टैंड no doubt today we can you know ask money and if our we have you know good transactions with the bank or if the our assets we are having good value of assets or if our credit worthiness is high then bank can provide me good sum of financial support good amount I may borrow from the bank to meet my requirements but you know आई कैन बोरो द अमाउंट नो डाउट, बट द क्वेश्चन कम्स कि हाउ कैन आई पे दैट नो इंटरेस्ट इन फ्यूचर एंड हाउ कैन आई पे द प्रिंसिपल इन फ्यूचर, वट एवर अमाउंट आई हैव बोरोड, व्हाट इज दैट अमाउंट आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू पे. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट बोरोड अमाउंट आई हैव टू पे समथिंग एक्स्ट्रा व्हिच इज नोन एज इंटरेस्ट. So, due to my credit opinion, due to my past transactions, my CIBIL score is very good, so bank is ready to give me the loan. But now, before taking any loan or any that financial support or any advantages of this credit, you know, I have to think that what will be the cost. So let us know that. So when you talk about cost, so cost of credit is first means the extra amount we shall be paying, right? So that is known as interest. So the interest is in a technical term, we are using that the cost of using someone else's money. Because this is not our money, we are borrowing that money from the financial institutions, it can be bank or maybe from individuals. So far that is not our money, and if we are borrowing that money for our purpose, for our usage, so in that case we have to pay something extra. And that is known as interest. The cost of using someone else's money is known as interest over here. Now we will see what is our next. Now then another thing is that principal. Principal is the total amount that we have borrowed, the amount of loan which we have borrowed. Now here again another factor is that rate, interest rate. So not only we are talking about interest, we are also talking about interest rate. So interest rate. We are defining the amount in terms of the percentage. When we talk about interest rate, it is the percentage of interest charge. Okay, so this is how interest rate is defined. Interest rate means when we define the interest in a percentage manner, so that is interest rate. And the time also plays a major role. So time will decide that how much amount I'll be paying on the credit. Okay, how much according to the time. It will decide how much cost I have to incur. If I am using someone money for more than 10 years, okay, or more than 5 years, in that case, suppose if I am using for more than 10 years, then definitely the cost will be much higher than if I am using it for 5 years. Right? So, as for the usage of someone money, if the length would be more, if the time would be more, then cost also would be more. So that's why there is a direct relationship between interest and the time. If you are using the credit for a longer period, then interest will be more accordingly. If the time period is shorter, then interest rate will be shorter accordingly. So that depends upon an individual how he is making the plan. So that's why you are going for credit management. So how a person is going to making the plan that how effectively you can utilize the credit sources. So always the time, as you have seen, it has increased in terms of years. Right? So when it is a bank loan, so it is always represented in terms of years. But again, there are some expenses, like auto expenses, even some like consumer. Credit would be consumer credit, for example, EMI facilities and other things. That means in terms of month also, you may get. But in general, when we take loan from a bank, particularly, so we go for a year. For how many years we are taking the loan. So now, cost of credit and we need to find out a picture that is time. Right? So, time plays a major role whenever we are estimating the cost of credit. So again, as for the time, we go for simple interest calculations. As for simple interest calculations, as we know, this is the formula that we know from our life when we came to know about the cost aspect and interest aspect. So interest we can determine with the help of this formula, principal into rate into time. So accordingly, we are going to determine the interest amount, that extra amount, what will be paying on a particular day. So, T is year. So, definitely, we are writing multiple years, like 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 1 to 3 years, like that. we are representing in terms of month as a whole business. Some know that loans, when you take the loan from a bank for like 6 months or 9 months, so in that case, it is in between 12 months. So in that case, it would be divided by the number of months. And also sometimes, like in case of credit card, when we talk about, it is in terms of days, 45 days. In that case, when we talk about days, then the time can be divided in by 360 days. So in case of only T, we are going to make the changes. Right? If it is year, then it's okay. Number of years accordingly, it will be multiplied. But if it is like month, so in that case, you have to divide. Like it is a month, so again, accordingly, you have to divide that value with the number of years, number of months. If it is a number of days, then accordingly, you have to divide it with the. Now, definitely the amount or the extra amount which will be paying, sometimes we are paying on a maturity date. We are finding out that. Suppose today we are giving a person 10 lakh rupees, we are giving to Mr. A, and we want that on maturity date, how much amount will be recollecting from him? So it cannot be 10 lakh, it will be definitely more than that. So maturity date means the date on which the loan must be repaid. So whether you are going for installment, whether you are going for EMI, whether you are going for partial payment, whatever it may be, every loans or every payment has a time period, and the time on which or the date on which the total amount would be repaid or total amount would be collected. It would be settled, that is known as. So in that case, we are considering the date and the maturity month also. Here we have the maturity date in the same day of the month that the loan was made. So accordingly, we will charge the interest and accordingly, we will collect our extra amount and repay the loan amount. For example, 1 month loan on January 15th, we get due on January 15th. So that depends on which date you have taken the date and the month. Accordingly, we will count the maturity time and maturity date. So that is all about month. Now it is day. So determine the day the loan was made and then count the exact number of days of maturity. So if you consider the days, if it is for 28 days or if it is for 45 days, as we have seen in a credit card, where you give 45 number of days for the repayment of the loan amount or the usage amount, so in that case, after 45 days, definitely you are going to charge the usage amount and which you have to pay. So like here, an example, a 90 days loan made on March 4th. So here a credit facility has been given for 19 days, 90 days. So in that case, again, and the loan made on March 4th will be due on June 2nd. So this is how we are going to calculate the maturity date, which plays a major role in our credit management. So now, installment interest. So what you call as an installment interest here? When a loan is repaid in partial payment, so we have taken the loan, and the loan payment we are not making on the date of maturity. We are paying that amount every month, and we are making a partial payment in a regular interval, which is a fixed sum. Okay, a fixed sum of amount every month we are going to pay to that party for the recovery of the loan amount. So how do you do that calculation in that case? So as we know, how to calculate the interest, the simple interest formula. So we calculate the total cost of the loan. As we know, this is the interest part and the total cost on the borrowed amount will be a principal plus interest. That is the total cost to us. Suppose today we are taking 10 lakh, 7 lakhs after 5 years, plus the interest for the 5 years, for the using of that fund for 5 years, whatever you have utilized, against that you have to pay interest. So 5 lakh plus, suppose the interest is coming 1 lakh, so 6 lakh you have to pay. So 6 lakh will be the total. The total cost, how you are calculating interest plus interest, which is due to that party, which you have to pay to them. Now, so further, we are going to calculate that number of payments. How many number of payments you want to make? Okay, based on how often you are required to make the payment. So, how often? Like, we are going for 6 months, or we are going for 12 months, or we are going for 24 months. So, accordingly, we are going to calculate the EMI. So, normally, we need to payment on monthly year. Okay? So, when you are going to make this payment on monthly wise, so the payment would be the equal like number of years, so consider the charge is 12 months. So, the year will have 12 months as you know. So, the total amount will be divided, the total cost will be divided into 12 months. So, as you see, where the payment would be, the installment payment will be total cost. This is no doubt principal plus interest divided by the number of payments. So 12, for 12 months, 12 number of payments. Now, increasing loan payment. When it comes, we are finding out here interestingly, decreasing loan payment. So, decreasing loan payment. Here the interest is calculated on the amount that is paid at the end of each month. So you might be knowing there is a reducing method, or there is a straight method. So now decreasing loan payment method, what will happen? Like the amount, the interest, and the principal would be there. The interest amount would be in the initial stage, interest amount on interest percentage will be more, and as for the time period it will decrease, and principal amount as per time it will increase. So in this method, decreasing loan payment method, interest is calculated on the amount of loan that is unpaid, right? So every month again it will be recalculated. How it will be recalculated? Every month. So in every month, like from the day one, we will see that in the first month we will charge the interest on whole amount, and in the second month we will just deduct that how we just see the closing balance of the principal amount. Okay, so interest would be calculated on that amount, on paid balance amount into interest. Now, remember, the amount of interest is based on the portion of the year. So, again, this year also you have to see, because suppose the loan was for 12 months. So, in the first month, it will be calculated for 12 months. The interest will be calculated for 12 months. But in the second month, it will be calculated for 11 months. In the third month, it will be calculated for 10 months. So, accordingly, it will be calculated. So, 1 month is 1 by 12 of the year, as you know. To divide. So interest rate for 1 month would be the annual interest rate by year. So monthly payment will be calculated with this value, interest plus loan repayment. So both these aspects will be considered for the calculation purpose. And we have seen while we are getting the statement from the bank that how they have calculated the value.
कैन यू हियर
हेलो
सर, इसमें लोग इंटरेस्ट कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, ये हम सिंपल इंटरेस्ट ही लगातार पकड़ रहे हैं, बट बैंक तो इसमें ये करता है सर।
हाँ, बैंक जो करता है वो कंपाउंड कंपाउंड में करता है।
हाँ
हाँ, बैंक
तो ये हम लोग मतलब
हाँ, ये एक एग्जांपल के वे में मैं दे रहा हूँ, ठीक है। लेकिन प्रैक्टिकली जो बैंक कैलकुलेट करता है वो कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट में कैलकुलेट करता है, जिसका जो फॉर्मूला होता है P = 1 + i to the power n, ठीक है। हम उसके ऊपर भी प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम करेंगे, ये बस समझने के लिए, ठीक है?
ठीक है ठीक
ओके। नाउ अनदर टर्म, डिक्रीजिंग इंटरेस्ट रेट दैट यू हैव अंडरस्टूड। नाउ एनुअल परसेंटेज रेट, दिस इज अनदर मेथड वी हैव हियर। सो एनुअल परसेंटेज रेट, हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट दिस वैल्यू? ए डिस्क्लोजर रिक्वायर्ड बाय द लॉ ऑन ऑल क्रेडिट एग्रीमेंट। ओके, सो इट इज ए स्टैट्यूटरी रिक्वायरमेंट व्हेन यू गो फॉर एनुअल परसेंटेज रेट, ए डिस्क्लोजर रिक्वायर्ड बाय लॉ ऑन ऑल क्रेडिट एग्रीमेंट, एंड इट इज अ मैंडेटरी वन। एंड एज यू हैव सीन, व्हेनेवर यू आर गोइंग फॉर द लोन दैट रिक्वेस्ट और लोन एप्लीकेशन, व्हेन यू आर गिविंग इट टू द बैंक, दे गिव अस ए लॉट ऑफ पेपर्स, ओके, एग्रीमेंट सेट दे आर गोइंग टू गिव अस, इट हैज बीन प्रिपेयर्ड एज पर द लॉ। सो हियर स्टेट द परसेंटेज कॉस्ट ऑफ क्रेडिट ऑन ए ईयरली बेसिस। So, which you know, they are going to state that, or they are going to represent that to how much percentage you will charge on their credit. Also, it includes the service charges and other charges which the bank wants to give. Okay, so this is not only by interest they want to, you know, they want only to collect interest. They also want that you know, that some service charges, some interest charges, or cash charges they are going to charge while we are granting the loan. In some cases you might be knowing they charge before for processing fee, right? So processing fee also it cost me a person who is going to take a loan. So the administrative charges or processing charges, they also include all these things which is written there in the bank agreement while we are going for a loan. Now the factors and the documents will be considered while we are going for a credit. So, you know, while we are approaching to a bank or somebody is approaching us for financial support, so best example, let us take it as a bank. So, what are the like things or documents which a bank wants to see? So, first of all, there is emphasis to the character of the person that who is going to give us the application. So, honestly, so honestly to say, you know, that they are going to see their character, that is on the basis of their account deposits, they are dealing with the people, okay. But the character, it is a very it's a very important topic. Again, the character to whom they are assigning, it is very difficult to know that whether that person is honest or not. You know, that depends upon his like working behavior, the banking transactions, right? So from there we just analyze and we perceive that, you know, this person is coming under this character. So a character is an important element when we talk about seize of credit. So the bank is to see the character of a person. In which we are finding out the honesty to create that for the credit. So that can be seen from our last record, debt record. The past debt obligations were handled accordingly, and we asked for the last 6 months transition, and you know, through that we are going to measure it, that whether he is a regular payer or not, whether he is a good customer for me or not. So now capacity. The capacity means that it's referred to a person's ability to pay the debt when it is due, right? So character, one thing that is bank statement showing that he is a regular payer, he do not have any default payment on his loan and past loan, you know, that the past debt, so he has a regular payment characteristics, so it is okay. So his character is honest and he is. Now they are going to see the capacity. Capacity is all about ability to pay. Ability to pay in the sense, now the persons to whom they are going to give the loan, whether he is financially capable or not. For example, Mr. A, he belongs to a family where the family is very rich. Okay? Now, Mr. A, father, Mr. X, is very rich person. So it doesn't mean that bank will give loans to Mr. A बाय सीइंग द फादर पेरेंट नो ये व्हेन मिस्टर ए वांट्स अ फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट टू हिज बैंक देन बैंक इज गोइंग टू सी द फाइनेंशियल कैपेबिलिटी एंड कैपेसिटी ऑफ दैट मिस्टर ए हु इज आस्किंग एंड हु इज गिविंग द एप्लीकेशन सो दैट इज हाउ because it doesn't mean that you know the son can ask money to his father and he can repay the amount of money so he cannot take that much of it so who is approaching you are going to see the capacity of that person so in a three phase the second phase is capacity now then again through that we are going to see that how much debt that person can handle as per his financial status as per his asset holding, he can, the bank can decide how much amount can be handled by that person or how much amount can be given to him so that he is able to pay it in a systematic way or without facing any difficulty. Now, capital. Last C of credit is, which is going to be measured by the bank, is capital. The capital is all about current available assets that could not be used for repay debt if income was to be declared unavailable. So that is what capital they are going to see. Sometimes the bank they ask, do you have any deposits or bank account statement when they ask for last 6 months, no doubt they are going to see the paying behavior of a person. Also they see how much money he is going to maintain every month for meeting the requirement. Also, they are going to ask that what is your spending behavior. They are going to see that what is your consumption, how much money you are saving, how much money you are doing for household expenses. So accordingly, they are going to find it out the, what would be the central amount. So capital here is the current available asset. Which can be like the property, what is that, at present, the balance, the insurance, all these things we are going to see, and accordingly, the bank will decide that we will do. So, Rajesh, here we have only three things, but in the books, you could find out there are five things right here. Okay? There are five things, six things. So, as per the, revolution in the banking system. Okay, this has been increased. So it is not only character, capacity, capital, there is also collateral conditions for C. Right? If we talk about 5 C again, conditions, collateral, that are also going to be measured by the bank. So these are the things in the 3 C we have. Okay. So credit applications. When you talk about credit application, the form on which the person provides the information needed by a lender. Lender can be individual or a bank. And accordingly, he will take the decision whether to take the credit or not. Now, credit reference means what? As you know, so far we are dealing with the banks. So whenever we go for a credit, the bank also asks for to give a reference because while we are working, the bank also wanted to know and if it is required, they are asking our peer group to whom we have given as a reference, asking how he is, whether he is mentally sound or not, whether he is a good person or not, but only this thing, how he is dealing with the business. So accordingly, they are going to see that. Okay? Then they see the application should be filled out completely with accurately and honestly. So so that proper review can be done and accordingly the bank can grant the loan. And it requires the signature, as you know, only proof whatever can support to consider that application for the loan and advances. A credit worthiness is what? An assessment of the livelihood that a borrower is default on their debt obligation. Okay? So, even if suppose today he is working and tomorrow suppose due to some reason his job would be not there, then how can he pay the due? Okay? So, this is how the bank is going to assess the credit worthiness that person is capable enough to take the depth application or not, in case there would be any risk or any uncertainty. Now that will be based upon the historical requirement and the credit score. Nowadays it is very essential that if you have a good credit score, that is a CIBIL score. As an individual, if you have a good CIBIL score now, if it is above 650, then definitely at any point of time bank is ready to give you the financial support. You might be knowing the bank also has some pre-sanctioned loan. The bankers are nowadays calling the customers and saying, sir, your credit score is very good and you have a pre-sanctioned loan. That means only you have to give the loan amount has been ready. Only the customer has to accept that. And from that day onward, the interest would be increased. So there is a pre-sanctioned loan facility that has been, nowadays enacted by the Indian bank. Now, documenting credit data, which is essential by the financial institution. So credit data makes up the information that the applicant provided on credit application. When we talk about the credit documentation, this is being maintained by the banks. The documentation on credit data may be verified by the employers. When we talk about employers, then the type of data would be like employment date, salary, because bank needs to ask you these things that your current employer, your payslip, these things they require to know that. Then type of data like saving and saving or taking other accounts, whatever you have. All these things they ask for to know your employer details. Now financial institutions, when you talk about them, banks people also do have institutions. So these are the documents they definitely require, and personal references they are going to see, no matter how personal business is conducted, whatever reference you have given to the bank, they are going to see and verify the kind of people for that. Now the company that gather information on credit bureau, so that is known as credit bureau, as you have understood. So credit bureau is an organization who collect all your information. Nowadays all the data is centrally maintained. Right? If suppose it is not like that, today you are approaching SBI Bank, then you are approaching ICICI Bank. So ICICI Bank can easily track that you have every loan from SBI Bank. So that is the work of the credit bureau. So the company that gets information on credit users. The credit bureau sell lender credit information about credit users, such as debt record, payment history, and if any action has been taken to collect over these days. So all these things are there. The credit bureau play a major role, and credit bureau prepare a credit report to show the debt of an individual and how often the individual uses the credit and how many credit. So nowadays when a financier is coming to your place, he is only asking you the PAN card number. And your number and ID proof, from there you can easily trace out that how much loan from what are the sources you have taken, where you have default, how much money you have paid, which is unpaid amount. So all these things you can easily trace out from there. Now through main credit bureaus, we have in India as you have seen, TransUnion and HTM. So these are the credit organization credit bureau we have, which provides us with this information. Now credit contract. The credit documents must be contain credit contract. Credit contract is, as you know, contract is agreement between two parties who is agree to make their contract with a mutual understanding. Okay? The bank, he cannot force me to take a loan, or as an individual, I cannot force a bank to give me a loan. So it is a mutual agreement, so it is a contract between two parties where you respect each individual interest and the requirement, and if it is forward to us, then we are going into a contract. And we keep the contract and maintain the contract. So KWYC, as you know what you are signing. The contract, whatever agreement has been given by the bank, it is one that you have to read and you have to sign it. The credit contract is a legal binding document that allows debtors to use the credit to obtain goods or services. Again, we talk about credit documents. We have credit contracts. The credit contract where the debtor should know the content of the credit contract before signing, such as amount of finance charge, repairs covered, add-on features. Okay, you could find out, if you're taking a loan, and in between that, even if there's some financial crunch or financial crisis, in that case, again, you can add on, you can ask the bank to give some additional amount to you for to fulfill your financial requirements. So that feature also banks will help. So you have to see what are the features that is there. The reduction of finance charges in contract fee in full before the ending date. So premature payment, in that case, how much financial support or benefit will be missing. That also is there in the document, the credit contract. And you have to keep the contract copy also. Now in the credit document, we have statement of account, that is the bill, the record of the transactions completed during the billing period. And suppose you have purchased something and you have financed a transformer or a machine for your organization. In that case, how much amount you have paid, what are the quotation price, so accordingly, and how much loan you have asked to the bank. All these things we are going to keep record on that. So statement of account, that is the bill we are going to maintain. So record of transaction completed during the billing period, which includes balance that was due for the last 6 months, amount charged during the month. Okay. All these things we are going to make the thing, make details record here. Now, credit regulations, this is important. As you could see here, when you're dealing with credit, the company who is providing the credit facility is always having, in doubt whether the business will perform or not, or whether, the person will pay me the amount or not in future. So, credit regulation is there. So, in the credit regulations, we have like, Rakesh ji, do you have any doubt? Have you sir? Rakesh ji, कुछ doubt है?
नहीं सर, नहीं सर। हाँ
Okay. अच्छा, इतना करें, अभी नेक्स्ट क्लास इज इट ओके, और
अब नेक्स्ट क्लास के लिए। हाँ
नेक्स्ट क्लास में कंटिन्यू करते हैं, ठीक है?
यस। थैंक
ओके, थैंक यू, गुड नाइट.
यू सर।